Hello, and welcome back to Jusant. That was not what I wanted to happen. Oh, we went for that one already. So, we've been here. Oh no. We need to be quick about those. Don't. Well, we've fallen for the first time. So you did work after all. We made it. Well, we made it somewhere. Oh. Might look like a bit of cheating, but I'm just using the resources we have available. Always want to react the way I not this one. Oh, you cannot hold on to those. Okay. And that's not enough. Thank you for your help. There are so many people climbing down from the heights. I feel like a fish swimming upstream. Like in the stories. Before the Jusant, we rose and fell with the tides. I remember hearing the old schooners describe enormous waves, ones that drove people upward with each high tide. They would never see in the ocean themselves. They were just repeating what they would hear from their elders when they themselves were young. There must have been a grain of truth to those stories, right? The ocean nourished the cliffs, and in return, the cliffs nourished the entire tower. Anyway, the inhabitants of low tide set enough store in them to set off in search of the ocean. I waver too. Should we try to hook the lost water? In a way, yes, but not by going with the flow. I have the answer now. Thanks to Arlo and Becca, we need to get back to the source. We shared our shady spot with a man named Zoid. He was on his way down to the plane and tried to convince us to go with him. Why stay? He didn't understand why we wouldn't go.
You wouldn't get nothing out of this field no more. The earth ain't worth a blessed thing.
He grabbed a fistful of dust and held it up as a proof. Zoe continued on his way while we prolonged our break, dreading having to go back out into the blazing sun. I refused to believe him. Ever since we set off, I feel like I'm rediscovering the tower, like I've never truly looked at it or listened to it before. My perspective's changing the higher up we go. I'm sure we're on the right track. To the person who left a caramel bun in the canteen. I ate it. Sorry, not sorry, there's no one around anymore anyway. Cass. Sada, what's new? Any work for us? Orders are drying up and business at the ropeworks is far too slow for my liking. I'm starting to get bored. I've brushed up on all my notes and I've done the accounting I've been putting off for cycles and Ulf does it all the machines. But now we're stuck twiddling our thumbs. We're not very good at doing nothing. Glad to know there's still someone left on the tower. Sada went with the flow, just like everyone else. I don't really see what they're expecting to find in the desert. It's not like the sun's going to budge any more than it does here. No need for new ropes, but you're welcome to come by whenever you like. You'll soon get used to doing nothing, you'll see. It suits us anyway, we have more time for each other. To make it. Ah, okay, I see. A little bit more. Come. Okay, if we were able to catch that, I think we would already do that. Oops. Then maybe over there, but that means we need a lot more. A little bit more. Oh. Oh, they stop. That's bad. Because we cannot create another one. How far do we need to go back? I think we don't have enough rope. Okay. Oh. Nope. We need to rest here. Because unfortunately we don't have enough rope to do it in one go. Which is really a shame because we were so close. I think I know. And from here we can go over there. Okay, and that is where I'm gonna end this part. So for now, thank you very much. Stay alive and see you soon. Bye!